The second wave has rolled out. Millions of Indians have been affected by it, and it looks even more dangerous than the first wave. Our mistakes lay in assuming that the pandemic is over too soon. The virus has yet again sunk its teeth on our flesh, and this time the marks will be deep.
We have brought it upon ourselves. No masks and reduced use of sanitizers have brought us down. Added to it are forgotten protocols of social distancing and indiscipline in public places, riding on crowded buses without masks, and traveling on trains without discipline has endangered thousands others.
Even though the instructions were pretty clear and there were ominous signs of a second wave, our marriage parties, vacations, long drives, enjoyments continued in a grand style. It was quite understandable that we needed to get out of our homes, but not in such grand fashion.
While searching for our lost and freeing ourselves from this oppressing virus, we have gone a bit too far, at a point where we have been pegged back and jailed again at our comfortable homes. While the upper class of the society remains at comfort, but their daily wage earners are staring at empty stomachs and help from the government.
As responsible citizens, it becomes our duty to help the poor in need. If the economically stable families once come forward to help the poor, then we might save our stomach from going hungry for a day. Let's start with our housemate and help our community out first.
But in doing so, we shouldn't compromise on our safety. Our well-being depends on our hands, and only we can keep ourselves safe. Wearing two masks, one cloth mask above a surgical mask, is very necessary to stop the spread of this virus, because we take it in when we inhale and give it out while we exhale.
Use gloves and head cover whenever you go out, since we cannot use PPE kits. We should always sanitize our hands whenever we want to eat food or touch our face with the hands. Whenever you go out, always carry sanitizer.
Social distancing is the call of the hour. Avoiding crowded places, even with protective gears on, is a must. Through this social distancing, we can curb the spread of the virus. As the situation worsens, calls for help shouldn't fall in deep fears, and we should definitely help each other in all possible ways we can.
Everyone must register themselves and get the doses of vaccine as soon as possible from the nearest hospital. Everyone above the age of 18 must take the vaccine when available to protect themselves and their family. Self-isolation is must if symptoms are noticed. Remember, you are responsible for your family's well-being.
Everyone must keep a note of the availability of oxygen services, food services, and beds in hospitals at all times. You might need it in times of emergency. It is never too late to keep yourself safe. In these trying times, we must keep ourselves positive, try to be happy, and take every precaution possible to stop the spread of this virus.
We will all fight together.
Stay home, stay safe.
We will all fight together.
Stay home, stay safe.